Hello and welcome back to Vice Versa. If you haven't tried using image prompts in Midjourney, you're missing out on a powerful tool. Today, I'll show you how to leverage images as part of your prompts, and we'll explore the magic of image-to-image creation. It's mind-blowing how good the results can be. Let me walk you through the process step by step. Let's start with a basic prompt structure in Midjourney. We all know text prompts are essential, and I have covered them extensively in my previous videos. But the real gem is adding images to your prompts, a technique often referred to as image-to-image creation. To begin, you'll need a URL for the image you want to use. First, grab the image you want to use as a prompt. The easiest way is to send the image to yourself on Discord. Right-click on the image to copy the link, you'll need it later. Now here's the exciting part. By combining your image with the text prompt, you can achieve stunning results. Start your prompt by typing /imagine, followed by describing what you want the generated image to look like. For example, a boy playing with depth of field, a 35mm lens, natural lighting, uplight natural features, and a photorealistic style. Before hitting enter, hit the space bar and then paste the copied image link. Control V. After that, hit space bar again and add --iw image weight, followed by the weight you want to give the original image. The weight can range from 0.5 to 2.0, where 0.5 is the lowest and 2.0 is the highest weight. The default image weight in Midjourney is usually 0.25, which means the image's influence is around 20% compared to the text prompt. But by increasing the image weight using --iw and a number, you can make the image have a more significant impact on the generated result. For example, I used --iw 2.0 to give the uploaded image maximum weight, making the generated art as close as possible to the original picture. Once you are ready, hit enter, and Midjourney will create the image based on your prompt and the uploaded picture. It is astonishing how well it works in version 5. Now, you can sit back and watch the magic unfold. The results are mind-blowing and the generated art will amaze you. Now, let's explore the possibilities of image-to-image prompting. If you are an artist, you can digitize your drawings or sketches by uploading them as a part of the prompt. The results are outstanding. You can also blend two or more images together without needing any text prompt. The blending techniques allows you to create unique scenes and characters by combining different elements seamlessly. Another fascinating application is placing yourself in AI-generated images. Just add your headshot as part of the image prompt, and Midjourney will make you part of the scene. It's like creating AI selfies. Using reference images, you can transfer artistic styles onto your Midjourney images. Whether it's an unknown artist's style or your own unique flair, Midjourney can match and incorporate that style into your generated art. Additionally, if you encounter difficulties describing a pose or orientation, add a reference image showing what you want to achieve, and Midjourney will understand your intention better. Moreover, using screen captures from movies or films, you can transfer their lighting and style onto your own images, creating stunning compositions. When you want to get specific details right, like body shapes or intricate elements, using images as prompts becomes indispensable. By showing Midjourney what you want, you increase the chances of getting exactly that. So, don't overlook image prompts in Midjourney. They unlock a world of creative possibilities. Let us know how you are using your image prompts in the comments below. And if you found this video helpful, remember to like and subscribe to our channel. That's it. Midjourney is truly incredible. Thanks for watching and happy creating. Let's make something amazing together.